Okay, that was a lot to remember. So moving on now, one of the most important things to remember about Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis is that... Hi guys, welcome back to another video. And just to start off, I really appreciate every single one of you who takes time to watch my videos and follow me on my Crohn's disease journey. Even though I am 12 years into this journey, I've only just recently started being public about it. I still appreciate every single one of you that takes the time to interact with one of my pages. If you want to follow more of my experiences and check out my social media pages, you can find the links in the description box below, and make sure you hit that subscribe button in the corner of your screen. Now, even though I've done a video on my Crohn's disease story, I realize I haven't actually explained what Crohn's disease is to those of you that may not know what it is. So this is pretty much the purpose of this video, just the simple basic facts on what Crohn's disease is. So let's just get straight into it. Crohn's disease is one of the two main forms of inflammatory bowel disease, or IBD. The other main form is ulcerative colitis. Crohn's disease can affect anywhere from your mouth to your anus, and it's basically characterized by chronic inflammation of your digestive tract. Now, focus on the word chronic here. Chronic means long-term. So Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis are lifelong conditions. But most people don't know Crohn's disease just doesn't affect your intestines. It can affect your eyes, skin, liver, bones, kidneys. It affects your whole body. So a lot of people with IBD do have other complications with their body. So now the cause of Crohn's disease is actually still unknown, but there are a few working theories, such as it has been suggested that your genetics play a role. So the combination of the genes you inherit could potentially make you more susceptible to getting IBD. Crohn's and colitis are known as an autoimmune disease because it's thought that an abnormal reaction by your body's immune system could potentially cause the inflammation that is seen in the disease, along with other environmental triggers. There are other factors such as viruses, bacteria, even the food we eat, and even smoking that have been suggested as a possible contributing factor, but there is actually not enough evidence within the literature or being researched to support this. So the symptoms you could experience, and bear in mind not everyone will experience the same symptoms at the same time or even in the same order. So for me, I constantly felt like I had the flu and I was always run down and fatigued before even experiencing some of the major, most obvious symptoms for Crohn's disease. So look, the bottom line is, for the first 16 years of my life, before I even started experiencing symptoms, I was fine, my gut was fine, but at some point I was exposed to something, or I did something that made them go, hold up, let's have a bit of fun here, time to shake things up a bit. So common symptoms for both Crohn's and colitis include experiencing abdominal pains and diarrhea. In some cases, there may only be mucus present after a bowel motion, but most obviously, if there is blood after a bowel motion, then that is a literal red flag that you could possibly have either Crohn's or colitis. It could also mean you could have some other disease, but for the focus of this video, we're just going to say Crohn's and colitis. As I said, the bleeding after a bowel motion is the obvious sign, but the blood may not always be obvious depending on where the bleeding occurs within your digestive tract. So depending if the disease portions are higher up or lower down will determine the colour of the blood that is passed. So if you're bleeding, and the bleeding is caused by the disease, so think about it, inflammation is injury to your body, and if you're injured, you do show signs of damage, and in this case it is blood. So if the bleeding is occurring higher up in your intestines, it may come out sort of black and dark in your poo, basically, because it has time to congeal as it's worked its way around your intestines. If it's fresh, bright and red, then that suggests bleeding is lower down, so probably somewhere in the large intestines. So yeah, the blood may not always be obvious, and depending on the colour of the blood depends on where the bleeding or the inflammation is within your body. So I've mentioned abdominal pain, diarrhea, and the blood and mucus in your stools. You could also feel very fatigued, especially if you're losing a lot of blood after each bowel motion. And you may have, you may experience appetite loss and experiencing weight loss as a result. In most cases, and especially if you've got a lot of bloody diarrhea, you may develop iron deficiency anemia, which can contribute to feeling tired and fatigued all the time. Now, just having these symptoms is not enough to give a firm diagnosis, so you will need some tests and investigations done. You'll most likely need a blood test to check your inflammation markers, so your CRP levels, and also you may need to give a stool sample because your stool can actually show a few inflammatory markers as well. Most likely you would be referred to have some radiology tests where you will meet someone like me. For those of you that don't know, I am a diagnostic radiographer. So I'm someone that is able to carry out things like x-rays, CT, MRIs, and radiographers also carry out ultrasound scans, which all can be used to diagnose Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis. However, these tests can be inconclusive at times. So the best way to get a definitive diagnosis is to have something called an endoscopic investigation. So this involves inserting a tube with a camera at the end of it to be placed either through your mouth or up through your bottom to have a look at the different parts of your intestine. So if it's going through your mouth, it's looking at your esophagus, your stomach, and your small intestines. If it's going through up your bottom, which is known as a colonoscopy, it's looking at your large intestines, and it can just peek through to see the last portion of your small intestine. This is the best way to have a physical look of what your gut looks like from the inside, and it can be quite obvious straight away if there is inflammation. And most of the time you'll have a biopsy or a little piece of your intestine taken out, so the lab can test it and see if it has the classic signs of Crohn's or colitis. If you're interested to know more about the colonoscopy procedure, I've recently just had one and I've uploaded a vlog on that. So you can find it in the description box below. I'll put the link there. But also, with the advancement of modern technology, there's now something called a capsule endoscopy, which is basically a little camera in a pill, which you swallow, and it takes pictures at certain times and then uploads them to a server so your doctors can have a look at them. And then you essentially poop it out. I haven't had it done personally, so I don't know whether you have to collect the camera and return it, or if it's just a one-off thing you use. Now, just like the cause of Crohn's and colitis, it is unknown, as is the cure. At the moment, there is no known cure. So Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, to some extent, can't be cured, and so treatment is just aimed at managing the symptoms you would experience. Please don't believe anyone that tells you they have cured their Crohn's disease, because they haven't. A cure implies the disease is gone forever, but with IBD you can only get in remission, which means your disease is still there, it's just gone to sleep, it's inactive, and it's not causing you any problems at this moment in time. As mentioned at the beginning, Crohn's can affect anywhere from the mouth to the anus, and depending on which areas of your digestive tract is diseased will determine the type of Crohn's disease you'll have. So bear with me in this bit, there's quite a lot of long words. So Crohn's disease of the mouth is called oral Crohn's disease, no surprise there. If your esophagus, stomach and duodenum is affected, it's called gastroduodenal Crohn's disease. If your jejunum and ileum is affected, this is known as small bowel Crohn's disease. If the last portion of your small intestine, so your ileum, and the first part of your large intestine, the cecum, is affected, this is called terminal ileocecal Crohn's disease. The large intestine can also be affected with Crohn's disease, and one of the main differences between ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease is ulcerative colitis only affects the large intestine. So Crohn's disease of the large intestine is not the same as ulcerative colitis, but it's given a term called Crohn's colitis. Very confusing, I know, but that's just the terms it's been given. So Crohn's disease of the large intestine can be called colonic Crohn's disease as well. And if the last portion of your large intestine, which is the rectum, is affected, it can be known as perianal Crohn's disease. Ooh, okay, that was a lot to remember. So moving on now, one of the most important things to remember about Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis is that it affects everyone differently. And the same goes for the medications that are used. What may work for one person may not work for someone else, and vice versa. So the different medications used to treat IBD include aminosalicylates, corticosteroids, immunosuppressants, antibiotics, and biological drugs. There's too many of them to list individually, but those are the main classes of drugs used, and they can be used in combination with each other or in combination with surgery. I've actually done a separate video on what type of operations are available for Crohn's and colitis, so you can check that out in your own time. But for the purpose of this video, that is pretty much Crohn's disease with all the simplified facts. So it's one of the two main forms of inflammatory bowel disease. Symptoms can be abdominal pain, bleeding, fatigue, diarrhea, constipation. No one knows the cause. No one knows the cure. There's medications that can be used to reduce the symptoms, which can be used together or with surgery. And that is pretty much the summary of it. So if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channel, and I'd appreciate any feedback you'd like on any videos you want to see or any topics you want me to discuss. And I'll see you next week for another video. Take care. Bye-bye.